Scotland, August 7th, 2025. Scots were left in deep shock as Floris, the most dangerous summer storm in 20 years, struck with winds of 172 kilometers per hour, collapsing roads, cutting power, and paralyzing transportation. The sky darkened over Scotland on an early August morning. Just as Edinburgh's summer festival should have been in full swing, howling winds tore through the air and heavy rain poured over ancient rooftops. Then, exactly at 10 a.m. on August 4th, 2025, Britain entered nature's fury, Storm Floris. 3 days earlier, Floris was just a low-pressure system forming over the Atlantic. Meteorologists warned of odd summer winds, but nobody expected the strongest summer storm in years, a true climate monster. The Met Office swiftly raised the warning from yellow to amber in Scotland, meaning danger to life. The urgent message was clear: stay away from the coast, don't board ferries, don't drive, stay home unless absolutely necessary, and pray. Unprepared, over 22,000 homes across northern and northeastern Scotland plunged into darkness within hours as the power grid was destroyed. The damage escalated with each gust. 40,000, then 50,000 homes lost power. In the Highlands, winds reached a staggering 67 mph, 172 kilometers per hour, ripping off roofs, toppling electric poles, felling ancient trees like they were toys. And that was just the surface of Floris's rage. A Ryanair Boeing 737-800 staggered in the air as it tried to land at Leeds Bradford Airport. On the ground, terrified passengers watched the aircraft tilt as if slapped by the air. The pilot was forced to circle back. Three other flights, two British Airways and one KLM, attempted to land in Aberdeen but had to turn back due to severe winds. On land, chaos reigned. Scotland's and northern England's railway arteries were forced into a controlled shutdown. Network Rail bluntly advised, "Stay off the roads. No line is guaranteed safe." Dozens of rail lines were disrupted by fallen trees and snapped wires. At Glasgow Central, the Cuss family from Blackpool was stuck waiting for a train home after their air holiday. "Nine cancellations already," sighed Paul Cuss, 59. "We're hopping across stations like playing hopscotch just to get home." Meanwhile, on the Isle of Skye, a popular tourist spot, high winds flipped camper vans like they were paper. A white Indy camper van lay overturned on the road and traffic ground to a halt. Police issued an urgent warning. All mobile homeowners must find shelter immediately. Do not move until winds subside. Tourism was paralyzed. So was culture. The Royal Edinburgh Military Tattoo was cancelled at the last minute, its first cancellation in 75 years. Over 100 Edinburgh Fringe Festival shows were scrapped, leaving thousands of tourists standing in the rain, demanding refunds. Edinburgh Zoo shut down. Even the iconic Edinburgh Castle, visited by millions every year, pulled its shutters, unsafe to open. Floris turned a summer meant for laughter into a weather nightmare. Waves as tall as three-story buildings crashed into coastal roads. Pebbles, sand, even chunks of concrete were blasted from seawalls like artillery. Met Office experts warned of deadly danger from airborne debris. Cars along the coasts were shoved off course, windows shattered, awnings torn apart. On major bridges like Newcastle's Tyne Bridge and Highland's Dornoch Bridge, gale force winds forced full closures. transportation between North and South cut almost entirely. Operators like LNER and Avanti West Coast urged passengers, "Only travel if you must." Ferry crossings from Scotland to its islands were axed one after another, creating a soft blockade in peacetime unseen before. Behind the scenes, utility crews worked through the night. Helicopters scoured the massive damage. Rescue teams, electricians, rail workers braved lashing winds and heavy rain to clear fallen trees, restore power, and reopen tracks. Yet the chaos, broken cables, downed trees, blackouts, persisted into the night of August 5th, with many areas still unrecovered. This was the sixth named storm of Britain's 2024-2025 season, but the most dangerous summer storm in memory, according to veteran Met Office staff of over two decades. And the frightening part, it hit in summer, not winter, catching everyone off guard during the nation's biggest holiday period. Some regions faced flash floods and landslides. In the Highlands and Lake District, rain fell at up to 32 mm in 1 hour. Roads washed away, rocks and mud buried highways, vehicles stranded in remote mountain areas with no cell service or resupply. The Scottish Qualifications Authority delayed exam result deliveries to remote islands like Hebrides, Orkney, and Shetland. Weather was too apocalyptic. Many elderly villagers living alone were trapped in darkness with no connection to the outside world. The Scottish government urged residents to check on neighbors, especially the vulnerable. Minister Angela Constance warned, "If you must travel, treat it like a winter journey, not summer. Bring warm clothes, water, food, spare batteries, and a fully charged phone." By the morning of August 6th, Floris had passed, but left Britain devastated. Over 68 flights canceled, more than 100 performances halted, thousands of passengers stranded, tens of thousands of homes powerless, hundreds of ancient trees down, transport gridlocked across the north. But the most troubling message came from meteorologists. Floris is not an accident. It's a sign of a new future. A world where weather disregards seasons and can strike any time. Today was Floris, tomorrow it could be worse. After what Britain endured, that warning no longer feels like sci-fi. It's becoming reality. In midsummer, in a country used to rain, but this time, nature was no longer polite.